Craig David, what an honour it is to tap in with you right now.
It's a pleasure, man. Pleasure. How everything good?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you? Where are you?
I'm at home at the moment. I'm down in London, so...
Down in London. That looks like a very exotic London apartment. It's nice. It just reminds me of Miami, though.
Do you know what? The mad thing is that, like, I had to just try and bring some of the Miami sort of weather inside. So the central heating's up full. Like, looks like it's the whole kind of, like, I don't know, Amazon rainforest thing going on around me. So it feels hot in here, but go outside and you will learn real quick.
Isn't it horrible? Is that like one of your winter survival things then? Just heating up to 30 degrees. I mean, you're not even wearing a coat, man. You look so like cozy. I love it.
Do you know what? Keep the heat on. Wear like it's summer, like time colors.
Yeah.
Put some plants around you. You feel like, okay, we must be in Miami. And then, like I said, open that front door. You will know that you where you are right now.
Yeah, send someone else to get the milk if you need it. You don't need to be doing in your life.
Tell me about it. Tell me about it.
All right, so, I mean, we got to talk about your show, TS5. I mean, it's legendary status now. It was the place to be in Ibiza this summer.
Wicked. I'm so glad that you're feeling the Ibiza vibes, because that, for me, was like... I just had so much fun, because... I think for me, the USP of that show, in Ibiza in particular, is that it's so intimate, even though there's so many people there. It's like, you are so close to me, and we're like, give you a little high five, I can give you a little slap of the hand, bang. And I love that. And that's why I wanted to kind of still bring that, however big the venue is or what we're about to do, that you feel like it's intimate. So you can turn on and be like, oh man, this just feels like it's me and that person in the rave, having a good time. Do you know what I mean?
So, mate, it felt like a house party. The scenes, the instas I all saw, I was just like, oh, this is just the coolest thing. But like you said, it's intimate, but it felt huge.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I'm so glad that you're feeling that. Because I just wanted that, because on the island, there's a lot of really good parties going on there with huge DJs and stuff. And I was like, we just need to find something that's just a little bit slightly more unique, in the sense of I can perform and sing tunes as well as DJ. So why not use the space to make it feel like everyone's part of this, rather than being so far away and it being like just amazing light show, but you're so far. I want it to be like, no, we're real close.
Yeah.
And I've got to perform for you. So wicked, man. So yeah, it's exciting times.
Hey, did you go incognito to any other gigs then? Because I mean, you were there all summer. Was that like, did you have one that you're like, oh, this is the best?
Do you know what? I mean, it was a funny one, because we had like so many back-to-back shows from, I'd do Ibiza on the Tuesday, and then I'd go on and do another show the following day somewhere else. So I was kind of kept it moving. But when I did get those moments to go out, I pass by Ushuaia, see what was happening, go by Pasha and see what's happening down there. And it's good, because it just keeps you seeing what people are feeling from other DJs and stuff. So then when you go back to your own set, you're like, okay, that tune popped off. How can I do maybe an instrumental version of that and a new freestyle over the top? You know, you pick up some good ideas. So
that's cool that you keep it alive. And you basically just get your notepad out like, oh, that went well. So
it's true.
From Ibiza to the radio, you're bringing TS5 to us every Friday night. That is so cool.
Oh man, that for me is gonna be such a vibe. And the thing is, I just know the tunes that I'm gonna be drawing for, and I want to pull for some songs that don't normally get played. So rather than just being, sometimes you can be a bit too cool for school because you want to play all the new songs.
Yeah.
And I remember that when I was a DJ growing up, I'd be like, oh, you get the new record and you want to play it. Whereas we've got such a collection of songs that I don't really don't hear as much. And I'm like, well, why don't I play that as well as something that's brand new? So you are in for a treat on the radio.
I'm so excited for this.
A treat.
And it must be a completely different thing though, because you know, like you've got a couple of Thou and Ibiza. Here it's kind of, you're in a studio, you don't get that. But the other thing you can have is a massive rave.
Do you know what I did, or what I'm going to do?
Yeah.
Is I want to do this from my home here in London. So I don't want it to be like a very sort of sterile studio. Oh, I know he's doing it, just him one in his... No, no. I want this to feel exactly as it did when I did my first Miami house party, because it was a vibe. It was in the house. There was people. So I'm going to create that whole thing again here in the UK. And I just want that to happen. So you know that actually this is a proper house party. He's at a rave right now, and you're going to hear it on the radio. So it's going to be wicked.
Man, just thinking about it. It's happening tomorrow night. And I'm like, oh, I'm cancelling everything, man. So you've got that going on. And then 2020, the dream continues because we are going on tour. We're going on tour.
Jeez. And do you know what's beautiful about it is that it's been 20 years since my first album, Born to Do It. So there's a real, I don't know, for me, it like feels like only yesterday. And I've got so many great memories growing up as a kid, like making that album. So to add a couple more of maybe the album tunes that I haven't done for a long time from that record in amongst I Know You, Nothing Like This, when the bass line drops and all the new stuff, I think it's going to be a really nice mix that people be like, oh, he played that tune, bro. Yeah. Oh, he did. So it's going to be a lot of that going on. And then all the arena shows, I mean, it's, oh, man, what a time. Jeez!
You were literally so excited about it. I love it. And the other thing is, because your music still has the thread of like your, you know, your first records and the stuff you're releasing now, it still feels like it's all the same package, but it's just evolved.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it. It's, you know what? It's just, I've been, I do this, you know, this thing where it's like, it's not just like a hobby to me. It's like, I love creating music. I love the excitement of knowing you just created something and that whole world hasn't heard it and you're the only one who's got this. And then the release of that music and then going performing it. I'm so in it that it just feels like I just hope it just lasts, like, you know what I mean? Till the day I can't write a song, you know what I mean? So,
which will we never, that is never going to happen, man. You're literally going to be releasing the photo. Do you ever look back at like you performing like 20 years ago and go like, yeah.
I was, you know, I was looking back because it was the other day, it was 20 years of Rewind. Mm. So I was like watching Top of the Pops on me performing. And you've got to remember, as a kid growing up, I was like, Top of the Pops was everything. I mean, to be on Top of the Pops.
Yeah.
And I mean, to rock up on there and also to sing live vocal for me was so important. Because I remember back in the day, they were like, oh yeah, you can come on, you can mime, you can do a thing. That's what everyone does on Top of the Pops. I was like, no, we are doing none of that. So when I listen back and I'm like, I'm just so proud that I fought that my way through to say, no, I want to sing this. So when I listen to it, I'm like, wow, I was actually doing it from, I was 17 at the time.
Yeah.
So, man, this is a little wicked. So it's such a journey I've been on. But yeah, good times. Some of the dance routine was interesting, but the singing was on point.
Yeah. I mean, we got a taste of, I mean, what we're probably going to expect at the arena tour at Hits Live. And your team saw me lose my mind. I've never seen something more incredible. Like live vocals, DJing, being your own hype man. I mean, you brought that all together and it just went off.
Thank you, mate. You know, I appreciate you so much. It's like the TS5 part is something I love because it's just like I can be really super spontaneous with it. Mm. And like you said, I can freestyle and I can drop an instrumental, play one of my favorite tunes and then play one of my own. But then also added in the full live band that I've got with me for the arena tour. It's going to be wicked because I want it to be like you get the live tunes, you get the feel of the guy playing the bass, you've got the guy playing the keys, and then all of a sudden we switch up and you're like, ooh, we're in that TS5 Ibiza Rocks Miami rave up. It's going to be nice. It's going to be good.
New Year's Eve plans. I hear you're doing something pretty damn cool as well.
Yeah, I mean, man, it's the gift that keeps giving. This, I always like this year's been like, and the next is like, so we're doing New Year's Eve, a full band show up until midnight. Then it's the fireworks over at Westminster. So that's going to be like, and it's going to be live on BBC One, which is going to be like crazy. And then after midnight, straight into TS5 and just rave it up throughout the rest of the night. So it's just mad that it's going to be, there's so many people that tune in. So it's going to be live on, like I said, on BBC One. But also, I mean, this is the London fireworks. I mean, this is not some kind of minor, oh, you know, you're in the garden and a couple of people blasting off some fireworks. Yeah. I mean, this is like the proper thing. And they're going to get some tunes. I mean, it just gasses me to think that the whole world who want to tune in and see the London fireworks will be, they'll be hearing some serious tunage at the same time.
And the other thing about it is they are the fireworks that are shown, you know, around the world when they do like the news roundups and stuff. And you'll be like, yep, that was me.
It's a mad one. And like I said, it's just crazy how when I got the call saying like, love you to perform in it. And I was just like, you know what? You have no idea how much of a statement this is. I mean, this is, as an artist to perform on that, it's like, wow. I don't know. I'm still kind of trying to like take it all in because it's a huge statement that I'm going to just make sure that people have a good time and they've set 2020 off on the right foot. You know what I mean?
You're going to smash it. You're going to smash your tour. You're going to smash tomorrow night.
Thank you, mate.
Big start to 2020.
Yes. Do you know what? got the arena tour, obviously, like we said, starting off with New Year's Eve like that. New album on the horizon.
Come through.
Something. I'm just glad that I can, because I know people like that don't really gravitate necessarily towards wanting to make bodies of work anymore because the climate's changed. But yeah. I'm just like, I feel like even if I run a certain amount of singles, I still need to have a body of work. So people like kind of expect it from me. My fans have been with me for a long time, so I've got a little album ready to put out there. So this is what
mate, that's the format I want, so keep it coming.
Done. I've got you.
Craig David, thank you so much. Good luck for tomorrow night. You don't need luck, man. It's just going to go off.
Nah, mate, you know what? I appreciate you. I really do. Have the most wicked, wicked day. And then I'll see you when I'm going to be up there soon anyway. We'll vibe like face to face when I come to the studio.
Yes, we need to do that.
It's all happening, but I appreciate you. You're a top boy.
Oh, mate, bless you. Thank you so much. Craig David.
Thank you, mate.